UK oil and gas has been in the spotlight since announcing earlier this week that oil has flowed to the surface at the Horse Hill site at a faster rate than expected. UK oil and gas has a 20% stake in the project located in the Gatwick area. CEO Steve Sanderson is on the line. Hello, Steve.
Hi there, Charlotte.
Now, Steve, yesterday we learned that initial flows from your first test at Horse Hill were already in excess of your own expectations. And today you have published an update on the flow test, which remains very encouraging, doesn't it?
Yeah, I think it's more than encouraging. As you know, you've said, this is really beyond actually my most optimistic prediction. So it doesn't happen very often. What we've got is a really sustained flow at over 450 barrels a day for, you know, 2 days or more now, with no sign of the pressure declining. It's very high quality crude. It's very light. It's equivalent to Brent crude. We've shipped our first two tankers of oil to be refined. I should point out, of course, that this oil comes from our deepest objective. We have three test objectives in this well, and this is the first one, from the Kimmeridge limestone. There are two Kimmeridge limestones that we're looking at. This is the deepest, and it comes from about 900 meters. So this is, I think, can be categorized as about the best well from in the UK in the last 15 years. It's very unusual for wells in the UK to actually flow of under their own pressure to the surface, but this one keeps on going. So, and if we look at it in terms of its peers in, say, the United States, from, you know, sort of tight oil wells there, this would actually be in the upper quartile. And we have to remember that this is only from a vertical well, not a horizontal well. So yes, it's a very, very pleasant surprise.
Okay. Now, with regards to today's statement and this second test you have done there, there was no water in the flow. Is that significant?
Yes, it means that we're basically producing from a very high-quality reservoir that really has no water ingress in it. It's actually as we would have expected for this type of rock, because it's basically right in between the rocks that generate the oil. So there is in fact no free water in these. So it's not unexpected actually that we have no water.
Okay, and what does the flow test mean in terms of commerciality?
Well, I think that. If we go back to some months, you know, ago, where we had NewTek and Schlumberger, you know, world class experts in evaluating oil in the ground, they said that there were billions of barrels in the ground under Horse Hill, and in fact under the 1,200 square mile area of the Weald. So, but that was fantastic. But it was still a slightly, shall we say, a science project. I think what this does now is that we've actually moved from science project really much to the verge of commerciality. The main objective for this well was to actually, in the limestones, the Kimmeridge limestones, was to show that there was movable oil, and that we could get them to the surface. So we've basically exceeded that objective. We've now, with these very high sustained flow rates, we've basically gone from science project really to the verge of showing that it's commercial. Now, clearly, we've only been flowing it for a few days. We will definitely come back to this well, and we will have to flow it over a much longer period so that we can actually ascertain, you know, what the exact recovery would be from each of these wells. But so far, the results are so beyond our most optimistic prediction that I think we are very much on the edge of saying that this is commercial.
Okay, but how long will it take until you know?
Well, how long will it take until we know? Well, we will have to stop testing this zone fairly shortly because we have two others to go to. And we only have a limited amount of time on our permits to flow test this. But we will have to come back, hopefully in a year or less, if we can get the permits, and then start probably a horizontal well in this at this location to put it on a long-term production test.
And if you wanted to bring this Horse Hill well into production, which is obviously the ultimate target, what are the steps, the key steps you would need to achieve to do this? You mentioned the permit earlier.
Yeah, we basically have to go through the regulatory process, through local planning authority, then the Environment Agency, Health and Safety Executive, and then finally from the Oil and Gas Authority. That's you can imagine, is an unusually long and laborious bureaucratic process. And we're trying to work with the government to try and make this a much quicker and shorter project. I think I'd also like to add, though, Charlotte, that I think one of the main things that this well shows is that we can extract oil from these Kimmeridge rocks at now what it looks like at potentially commercial rates. But we have to bear in mind that these rocks go over a very large area. These oil deposits extend over 1,200 square miles of the Weald, and also over the 55 square miles of these Horse Hill licenses. So I think this well shows that it's very significant for the company, because clearly there's a lot of oil under our licenses, and it looks as if we're very close now to establishing that we can get it out at commercial rates and quantities. But I think it's also very important for the UK, because clearly there's a very large prize. There's a lot of oil in there, and it looks as if we can get a decent chunk of it out. We've said about 5%. So clearly if this works and we can extrapolate to the 1,200 square miles of the Weald, then clearly we're looking at some significant boost to the UK economy in terms of billions of pounds to add to the economy, a lot of taxes, and a lot of jobs, a lot of direct jobs, and particularly induced jobs in the supply chain, and people supporting potentially a new industry, if you like, in the southeast of the UK.
Nevertheless, Steve, you are likely to encounter some resistance from local communities. That could be one of the hurdles the project will face. What about protesters, for instance, near the site? Have they had an impact on operations, or could they?
No, I mean, let me be frank. People are entitled to their own views, whether or not it's an informed view or not, so that's fine. We've had protesters outside, a small number to date, and they've had no impact on any operations. We have a good relationship with the local community. I think we've also demonstrated that if we develop these deposits, that we'll put all the wells below, the wells and pumps below ground level. The only thing that would be seen would be a few tanks about the same size of a grain silo, and we actually would control the production so that it would have the minimal impact possible on a local transport infrastructure.
And Steve, what would you say to the critics and the skeptics out there who claim that the project is barely viable, especially at today's oil prices?
Well, I think clearly at $30 per barrel, there's almost no project on the planet that makes significant amount of money outside of the few core OPEC countries in the Middle East. I think we were always looking at about a $40 break-even price for this type of project. I think the oil price is going to go up soon. U.S. shale production is now coming down, and it looks like OPEC and Russia might be sealing a deal. So I think if we get the price up to, in excess of $40, we'll be in business.
Okay, Steve, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Steve Sanderson, Chief Executive Officer at UK Oil and Gas.